How much money should you spend on your cybersecurity? That's a million, often multi-million dollar question. At ICI's recent cybersecurity conference, I got some fresh insight from one of the experts.
So people think about spending money on security, and the question is how effective it is. And so you spend a lot of money, how do you know that that money actually will prevent the next breach? How do you know how good your controls are? And if tomorrow something will happen, how do you know if those controls that you already put in place and invested money in will actually come to play in the right way?
So how can companies be more effective in their risk assessment?
So the first thing would be to think like the adversary. If you bring the adversary to the game, you already build your controls, you build your security program. Now bring the adversary and see how it plays. The wrong thing to do is actually to wait for the attack to happen. And if you do that, you're already too late.
And since it may not be natural for everyone to think like a bad guy, how do you need to do that? How do you begin to look around corners to see risk?
So it's more on realizing how an attack looks like. What are the phases? And what are you trying to protect from happening? And if you understand those two elements and you can play them, there's multiple ways to play them, then you're actually doing the right thing.
We've talked about risk assessment. What about risk mitigation? That can be a pretty tough fight. How do you fend off attacks?
Correct. And I think that the challenge is because a lot of people are focusing on the hacker's strength point and not his weakness. And if you look at how hacking has changed over time, over the years, it became more sophisticated, more complex, and that's actually its downside. So by really understanding how the entire flow of the attack works, you can find those weak spots where you have the advantage. And so not focusing only on where the hackers are stronger, but also on where you are stronger, and just focusing on mitigating those parts will actually break the entire chain.
You know, so many times too, and what people have begun to talk about is that it's maybe also time to move beyond the question of avoiding an attack, but also just coping with them. What are your thoughts on that issue?
I think it's a great mindset. So if you just stay away from trying to prevent everything, which you will never get 100% success in, and you're focusing on how can I actually reduce the impact? How can I, as you said, live with the attack, but make sure that the impact will be such that my business can absorb? And that's the main thing.
So a final question based on the discussion today. What's one action item you would identify for people in the fund industry to think about doing?
First of all, validate your assumptions. So either you're hiring your hackers, you know, take an automation platform like SafeBreach, or any other mean, just validate your assumptions and then start from there.